Warm regards to all viewers. It's nice being back with you with a lecture on interface. Introduction. Most cells divide one or more times during their lifetime. When they do, they pass an ordered sequence of events that collectively forms the cell cycle. The duration of the cell cycle varies greatly from one cell to another. The shortest cell cycle occurs in early embryo and can last as little as 8 minutes. The cell cycle of growing eukaryotic cell lasts from 90 minutes to more than 24 hours. Its duration varying considerably within a population of cells. The cell cycle of the eukaryotic cell is divided into two fundamental parts that are interphase and mitosis, including cytokinesis. Interphase is the period of non-apparent division, whereas mitosis is the period of division. Actually, for many years, cell biologists were concerned with the period of division in which changes visible under the compound microscope could be observed, whereas during interphase, no visible changes under compound microscope were seen. Even chromosomes were not visible in the interphase because the refractive index of the nuclear sap and that of the chromosome present in recondensed, hydrated, and despiralized state became identical. The whole nucleus appeared as idle. So, interphase was mistakenly considered as resting stage. During interphase of nucleus, several changes take place at the molecular levels that are not visible microscopically. Interphase is a period of intense biosynthetic activity in which the cell doubles in size and duplicates precisely its chromosome complement. So, this phase is also known as metabolic phase, and the nucleus is known as the metabolic nucleus. Moving ahead, we discuss interphase and its apparent phases. The time from the end of one mitosis to the start of the next mitosis is called interphase. It is the phase between the end of last telophase and subsequent prophase. This is the longest period in the cell division. Fulgent staining of metabolic nucleus followed by a cytophotometric quantitative assay first suggested that doubling of DNA takes place during interphase. Autoradiographic studies with labeled thymine demonstrated that doubling of DNA, that is replication or synthesis of DNA, did not take place throughout the entire interphase. It occurs only in a restricted portion of the interphase, the so-called S phase, that is the synthetic period. This period is preceded and followed by two gap periods of interphase, G1 and G2, in which there is no DNA synthesis. Thus, the interphase can be subdivided into three successive subphases such as G1, S, and G2, and it normally comprises 90% or more of the total cell cycle. G1 is the period between the end of mitosis and the start of DNA synthesis. S is the period of DNA synthesis, and G2 is the interval between the end of DNA synthesis and the start of mitosis. During G2, a cell contains two times the amount of DNA present in the original diploid cell. Following mitosis, the daughter cells again enter the G1 period and have a DNA content equivalent to a diploid cell. We will now study each of the subphases of interphase in depth, starting with G1 phase, the most variable period of the cell cycle. The period between the end of telophase and just before the entry in S phase is called G1 phase. The period of G1 is usually greater and is subjected to greater variation. Generally speaking, The S and G2 and mitotic periods are relatively constant in the cells of the same organism. But the G1 period is the most variable in length. It may contribute 25 to 50% of the total interphase duration. In some cells, G1 may be very short or absent. Depending on the physiological condition of the cell, it may retain in the G1 phase for days, months, or years. Cells that have stopped growing also become arrested at a specific point of G1. Example, liver cell, lymphocyte, etc. And the cells contain the amount of DNA present in G1 period. Arrested cells can be induced to divide again. For example, liver cells normally neither grow nor divide, but liver damage rapidly induces them to divide. Intensive cellular synthesis takes place during G1 phase. Mitochondria, chloroplasts, endoplasmic reticulum, lysosomes, Golgi apparatus, vacuoles, and vesicles are produced. In cells preparing for cell division, there is a marked synthesis of mRNA, tRNA, and proteins during G1, but there is no DNA synthesis. The enzymes and substrates necessary for DNA synthesis during S phase are also synthesized during this phase. Nucleolus produces rRNA and ribosomes. This is necessary for the entry of cells into mitosis, as inhibition of their production delays the entry of the cell into mitosis. As a whole, cellular metabolic rate is very high in G1. As a result, cell growth occurs. Commitment to chromosome or DNA replication in S phase occurs in G1 phase. If conditions to pass the commitment point are satisfied, after a lag, a cell will enter S phase. The conditions mean the nutritional state of the medium, the mass of the cell, etc. The commitment point is clearly observed in yeast cell, where it is called start. The comparable feature of the animal cell is called the restriction point. The next phase we consider is G0 phase. Some cells do not divide at all. These cells are often considered to have indefinitely withdrawn from the cell cycle into another state resembling G1 but distinct from it because they are not able to go to S phase, that is, the cells are arrested to non-cycling state. This non-cycling state is called G0 state or resting state, and the cells are called resting cells. Some cells, such as neurons, have left the cell cycle irreversibly and can never divide again. But certain types of cell can be stimulated to leave G0 and re-enter a cell cycle. Indefinite withdrawal from or reactivation into the cell cycle takes place effectively at an early part of G1 phase. The absence of nutrients or growth factors causes cells to enter a resting state. Yeast cells, starved of nutrients, or mammalian cells deprived of growth factors arrest early in G1 in the stage G0. G0 cells usually contain fewer ribosomes and less RNA than the corresponding cycling G1 cells, and they synthesize protein less than half the G1 rate. When a G0 cell is stimulated to grow by growth factor or by providing nutrients, changes in the rate of protein synthesis generally go hand in hand with effect on the chromosome cycle. The coupling between protein synthesis and the chromosome cycle is not always rigid. With suitable combination of protein synthesis inhibitors, and growth factors, it is possible to depress protein synthesis in cultured cells without delaying progress through the cell cycle, or conversely stimulate protein synthesis without stimulating cell division. Comparison of the size of a mammalian neuron and a lymphocyte reveal that both contain the same amount of DNA, but a neuron grows progressively larger during its development while remaining in a G0 state. During this time, the ratio of cytoplasm to DNA increases enormously. On the other hand, lymphocyte maintains its constant cell size and the definite cytoplasmic ratio by means of cell division. The following phase is S phase. S phase is the intermediate phase between G1 and G2 phases. When G1 phase ends, S phase starts. It is a highly specialized phase of interphase, and the word S stands for synthesis. Actually, DNA synthesis takes place in this phase. Before a cell can divide, it must produce a new copy of its chromosomes. For making a new copy of chromosome, it needs both the replication of long DNA molecule in each chromosome and the assembly of a new set of chromosomal proteins onto the DNA to form chromatin or chromatid. By its end, each chromosome has been copied to two complete chromatids, which remain joined together at their centromeres until the M phase that soon follows. The last phase is G2 phase. The period from the end of S phase until mitosis is called G2 phase. It is usually the shortest part of the interphase. In this phase, intensive cellular synthesis occurs. Mitochondria and chloroplasts divide. Energy store increases. Mitotic spindle begins to form. In the interphase, there are two control points, such as G1 or S and G2 or M, at which the cell takes a decision on whether to proceed or not to the next step. Two control points are also called checkpoints. This provides an opportunity for the cells to ensure whether all conditions are favorable for DNA replication or not, whether the cytoplasmic mass has increased to a level adequate for division or not, whether replication has been completed and thus DNA is undamaged. If the checkpoints did not give any green signal, the cells may halt in G1 or S or G2 or M. Some embryonic cycles bypass some of these controls at some stages of embryogenesis. Thus, the control of the cell cycle can be coupled as required to time, growth rate, mass, and the completion of replication. Furthermore, we talk about visualization of chromosomes during G1, S, and G2. Eukaryotic chromosomes undergo condensation-decondensation cycles at cell division. The DNA of prokaryotes is never cycled in this way. This is a specific difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes. The DNA of the prokaryotes can be replicated continuously in fast-growing cultures. During interphase, the chromosomes are decondensed and cannot be distinguished under the microscope. Using an experimental trick, it is possible to induce the condensation of chromosomes in all three stages of interphase. Mitotic cells fused to interphase cells using inactivated Sendai virus are able to induce premature chromosome condensation in the interphase nuclei. The prematurely condensed chromosomes from G1 nuclei show only one chromatid, whereas the ones from G2 nuclei have two chromatids. This is visualized that the G1 phase corresponds to the period of interphase, prior to DNA replication, and that G2 is the period of interphase that follows DNA replication. When S phase nuclei are fused to mitotic cells, a more complex pattern is observed. The chromosomes adopt a pulverized configuration. Lastly, we discuss the regulatory activities of cell cycle. The presence of different regulators at different stages of the cell cycle can be determined by means of cell fusion in different stages of the cycle. Cell fusion makes a hybrid cell. Hybrid cells are heterokaryons which contains two different nuclei in a common cytoplasm. Cell fusion can be induced in presence of chemical agents or using inactivated Sendai virus. Interphase nuclei during G1, S and G2 and mitotic cell, that is M phase, can be fused by various combinations which are as follows. When S phase cell is fused with a cell in G1, it reveals that both nuclei in the heterokaryon replicate DNA. This suggested that the cytoplasm of the S phase cell contains an activator or regulator of DNA replication. The regulator identified by this fusion is called S phase activator. The nature of the S phase activator is unknown. It could be regulator whose activation is decided when cells in G1 are ready to enter to a cycle of replication. When a cell in S phase is fused with G2 cell, the S phase nucleus continues to replicate, but the G2 nuclei does not replicate. This suggests that DNA that has been replicated once becomes recalcitrant to the effects of the S phase activator. It means that S phase activator fails to induce the replication of DNA of the G2 cell where DNA replication has already been completed once. But in this fusion experiment, the S phase nucleus enters M phase sooner than it would have in its former cytoplasm, but the G2 cell does not enter mitosis. This can be explained that some regulators in the S phase cell, possibly the S phase activator itself, inhibits the start of mitosis. When a cell in mitotic phase or M phase is fused with a cell at either G1 or G2 stage of interphase, it brings about the interphase nucleus to enter a pseudomitosis, which is characterized by premature chromosome condensation in the interphase nuclei. This suggests that a mitotic phase inducer is present in dividing cells. The existence of inducer can be proved by the fact that the fusion between G1 and G2 cells do not induce replication or mitosis in either nucleus of the heterokaryon. When S phase nuclei are fused to mitotic cells, a more complex pattern is found in which the S phase chromosomes have a fragmented appearance or pulverized configuration. It has also been noticed that blocking of DNA replication with inhibitors such as hydroxyurea prevents somatic cells from processing through S phase into G2 and M phase. Thus, a common feature in the cell cycle of all somatic eukaryotic cells is that completion of DNA replication is a prerequisite for cell division. Cycling cells undergo three major transitions during the cell cycle. The beginning of S phase is marked by the onset of DNA replication. The start of mitosis, that is M phase, is accompanied by breakdown of the nuclear envelope and chromosome condensation, whereas segregation of the sister chromatids marks the metaphase to anaphase transition. Cyclin-dependent kinases that are abbreviated as CDKs trigger the transition from G1 to S phase and from G2 to M phase by phosphorylating distinct sets of substrates. CDK1 and CDK2 bind to multiple cyclins such as cyclin types A, B, D and E, whereas CDK4 and CDK6 only partner D type cyclins. According to the classical model of cell cycle control, D type cyclins and CDK4 or CDK6 regulate events in early G1 phase. Cyclin E CDK2 triggers S phase, cyclin A CDK2 and cyclin A CDK1 regulate the completion of S phase, and CDK1 cyclin B is responsible for mitosis. Based on the results of cyclin and CDK knockout studies, scientists have constructed a new threshold model of cell cycle control. Accordingly, either CDK1 or CDK2 bound to cyclin A is sufficient to control interphase, whereas cyclin B CDK1 is essential to take cells into mitosis. The differences between interphase and mitotic CDKs are not necessarily due to substrate specificity, but are more likely a result of different localization and a higher activity threshold for mitosis than interphase. Hereby, we conclude the talk. Interphase is the growth period of the cell cycle in which the cells spend most of their time and perform their customary functions, including preparation for cell division. It is also considered to be the living phase of the cell, in which the cell obtains nutrients, grows, reads its DNA and conducts other cell functions. The majority of eukaryotic cells spend most of their time in interphase. This phase was formerly called the resting phase. However, interphase does not describe a cell that is merely resting, but is rather an active preparation for the cell division, and so the name was changed. When interphase begins, the chromosomes have not yet replicated, but by the beginning of the prophase, the replication is complete, so that each chromosome is composed of two sister chromatids. Replication occurs during the synthesis or S phase. S phase is preceded by G1 phase, which in many cells is a time when cell growth occurs. From G1, a cell may exit the cell cycle and go into a long-term stable state known as G0, where the cell functions but doesn't divide. At the beginning of the third and last of these substages, G2 phase, the replication is complete. During G2, the cell prepares for mitosis as it undergoes rapid growth. I hope this lecture will be helpful in your understanding of the longest period of the cell cycle, the interphase. Thank you.